Welcome to the YouTube channel of Transition. Today I'm going to discuss some important questions for ICSE 2019. So students, you know that your physics paper is divided into two sections, section 1 and section 2. In section 1 you have four questions. Four questions each is divided into 5 parts and 2 marks each is allotted to each question. And then in section 2 you have 6 questions out of which you have to attempt any 4. So those 4 questions are basically application based questions, then you have pictorial questions, conceptual questions and some numericals which usually consist of 3 to 4 marks. So today basically I have not prepared for you a list of questions, I have made it divided the important stuffs in the chapter forms. Okay. So we have what the topic based study which we need to do in our physics paper, because physics is a very broad syllabus we have in physics, so we cannot make out questions. So let us start with the first chapter. We have force. Okay. So under force, what are the topics which we need to cover is number 1, principle of moments. Number 2, centripetal forces. Number 3, centrifugal forces. So first let me come to principle of moments. Under principle of moments, what kind of question can come? First of all, you have to define or state the principle of moments. Secondly, you have to illustrate that in the form of a diagram. Secondly, you have centripetal forces. Again, you need to define the centripetal forces, and then you need to know the examples of centripetal forces. Like the question can be, explain the motion of a planet around the sun. So for that, you need to know centripetal force. Next, we have centrifugal force. Under centrifugal force, again, you have the definition for centrifugal force. And then you have to, that merry-go-round example in your book, you must have studied. So what do we have in that merry-go-round example? We have two persons, one standing on the platform of merry-go-round and the other one standing outside. So what are the observations of those two persons can come in your paper? Okay, so let us come to our next topic, that is work, energy and power. Under work, energy and power, we have measurement of work. Now, what kind of questions can come from measurement of work? We need to calculate work when the force is perpendicular to the displacement, when the force is parallel to the displacement, that is displacement is in the direction of force, and when the force is at an angle to the displacement. So we all are well aware of it. When the force is perpendicular to the displacement, we have zero work done, Fs cos 90. When the force is parallel to the displacement, that is they are in the direction of displacement, then the expression for work done is Fs. And when the force is inclined at an angle to the displacement, then the expression for work done is Fs cos theta. So this is what you need to write down in your answer sheet. So our next topic is examples of energy conversion. There are multiple examples mentioned there in your book. Please go through them. This is very important for this year. Maybe 2 or 3 questions can come from there. So like if I give you an example, like burning of a candle, photosynthesis. So what are the energy conversions taking place in this? That you need to know. Then our next topic is numerical based on power, work, energy theorem. So numericals I have mentioned in the description box, you can go through it. I have mentioned some more questions and numericals which you can see from there. Our next topic is machines. Under machines we have our first very, very important topic, that is the relationship between mechanical advantage, velocity ratio and efficiency. And this is one of the very common question in ICSE. You must have, if you have done your last 10 years, you must have seen repeatedly this question appears in your paper. So how this question may come in your paper this year is, first of all you need to derive the relationship between them, and secondly there can be a numerical based on this question. Then we have single fixed pulley. Single fixed pulley, what kind of question can come? For what purpose is single fixed pulley used? Now we know single fixed pulley gives us no gain in mechanical advantage. So another question can be like, name the pulley which gives you no gain in mechanical advantage. So the answer will be single fixed pulley. Is it clear? So let us move on to our next topic, that is block and tackle system. Now under block and tackle system, what kind of questions will come? Question number 1. They will give you a velocity ratio and they will tell you to draw a block and tackle system and label it. Label what? The tension, the load and the effort. So you need to label them with proper directions. Okay. Numerical on block and tackle system can also come. And lastly, this is one of the very important stuff you need to remember for this year, is why the lower block of the block and tackle system has to have negligible weight. So we all know, for efficiency to be greater on the greater side, the lower part of the block and tackle system should have less weight, so that friction and waves, all of these parts are excluded. So this will be the answer to that part. Okay, so now we are moving on to our next chapter, that is refraction at plane surface. From refraction of plane surface, the very first important topic is TIR. What is TIR? Total internal reflection. So from total internal reflection, the most important question is the conditions that are necessary for total internal reflection. This may come for you for 3 marks. Okay, now then we have our next expression which we have done in our courseware, that is this relationship. I hope you all have seen this relationship before. This is refractive index of second medium with respect to first medium, and it is equal to 1 by refractive index of first medium with respect to second medium. So how is this question going to appear in your paper? Like, you see, if the refractive index of glass with respect to air is given to you, refractive index of glass with respect to air is given to you, they will ask you refractive index of air with respect to glass. So this is how you are going to, just to make it the reciprocal. So you will get the answer for that. Okay, now let's move on to our next topic, that is apparent bending of stick in water. So question may appear that please draw a label diagram for apparent bending of stick in water. So this topic you need to do it very nicely. Now let us move on to our next chapter. Now all these three chapters are under light. I have divided it into parts. Okay, so see, next is refraction through lens. Under refraction through lens, there are many things which we have done. But the important ones are, first of all, the ray diagrams are very important. Suppose you may get a question that Rhea sees the image of an object twice the size. Okay, so whether she is seeing the correct in front of a concave lens. So is she seeing the correct image? So now the answer will be no, because we know concave lens never makes an enlarged image of an object. So such questions can come, application based. Okay, apart from that, power of the lens. So here you need to define the power of a lens. Next, they may mention you the focal length of the lens and you need to find out the power. So numerical based question. You know that power in diopter is equal to 1 by focal length in meter. So they can give you. Similarly, they can also give you, like, the power is plus 2 diopter, what kind of lens the person is using. So you know it is plus 2 diopter. So positive is always for convex lens. So the person is using convex lens. So this kind of questions can appear from power. Then next is ray diagram of lens, which forms a virtual erect and diminished image. Please focus on this question. They have not mentioned you which lens you are using. So you need to see the attributes of the image, virtual, erect and diminished. This kind of attributes belong to image formation of a concave lens. So here the question can be, what kind of lens is being used? So number one, concave lens. Second, please draw the ray diagram for the same. So you need to draw the ray diagram which you have done in your courseware. Now next part is ray diagram for object placed between f1 and 2f2. In convex lens, obviously they mention you the lens over here. So you need to simply draw the ray diagram. Okay, one thing I would like to share with you guys, it's very important, it's just struck my mind, that in ray diagrams, please don't miss those arrows. Many students, while I have been teaching and evaluating my students, they have been continuously doing that mistake, like they are missing the arrows. These arrows are very important as they depict the direction of the ray. So if you miss them out, you're not going to get any marks for that. Okay, so now let us move on to the next topic, that is spectrum. Under spectrum, we have that electromagnetic spectrum, right? So from that electromagnetic spectrum, most of the questions are expected. So what kind of the questions will be there? Like naming questions. Naming, they'll tell you radiation that is detected by thermobile. What kind of radiations are detected by thermobile? Infrared radiations, right? Then we have the radiations which are used for detection of fracture in bones. What kind of rays are used for fracture in bones? We all know, X-rays, right? Then radiations which have wavelength range 100 nanometer to 400 nanometer, ultraviolet rays. So such application based questions will be coming from the spectrum part. Also they may give you the wavelength of certain rays is this. Now name the ray, what is the speed of light of that ray in vacuum, etc, etc. So you need to do it accordingly. Okay, now let us come to our next topic, that is sound. Under sound, what do we have? The safe limit of sound level for human hearing. So you need to mention that limit and you should know what is the range for human hearing and all that. Okay, then we have characteristics of sound in relation to its waveform. Now it may not be waveform, it can be amplitude also, it can be pitch also, but if it is waveform, then what is the characteristics? It's quality. Then we have a pendulum question. Positively this year the pendulum question is important. Now how will this pendulum question appear in your paper? There will be that diagram which you have done in your physics courseware, and they will ask you about the vibration. So it will be in relation to the resonance. Okay, probably you all have done that. Then we have define some definitions like amplitude, frequency, we can have time period, wavelength, etc. And then definitely we have numericals on echo. This for sure that you will have a numerical on echo or a numerical on distance, time and speed. So you should know that. And I will mention, as I told you in the beginning of the video, that all the numericals and all the important questions which I have taken out, I will mention them in the description box. So you can take it out from there. Now we have the current electricity. From current electricity, Ohm's law is very important. So from Ohm's law, first of all, we define Ohm's law, and then there can be a circuit diagram for verification of Ohm's law. So you need to draw the simple circuit diagram, and not just the circuit diagram, you have to label that circuit diagram. Okay, so only that thing can come from Ohm's law. Then we have ohmic and non-ohmic resistor. Under ohmic and non-ohmic resistor, number one, define ohmic and non-ohmic resistor. Number two, differences between ohmic and non-ohmic resistor. Number three, V versus I graph of ohmic and non-ohmic resistor. And lastly, how do you find the resistance from ohmic or resistor graph? Like you draw a VI graph, how do you find the resistance from that graph? So you all know, if you calculate the slope, you will get the value of resistance, right? Okay, so that's it from ohmic and non-ohmic resistor. And yes, numericals, it goes without saying, current electricity without numericals, not possible in physics paper. It has to be there in the second part of the paper. Then we have household circuits. Now household circuits, again, I have made it part. It is under current only. So household circuits, the first one will be earthing. Why do we need earthing? What is earthing and why is it essential? Secondly, fuse and switch. Now we have studied that fuse and switch are connected in the live wire. So why do we connect the fuse and switch in the live wire can be a question in your paper. Lastly, precautions while handling switches. So what are the precautions which we need to take while handling switches? So we have done, we should not touch switch with wet hands and all those precautions. Two or three precautions are there which you need to mention. Suppose it's a 2 marks question, so you just mention 2 precautions you need while handling switches. Lastly, staircase wiring. I personally think staircase wiring is very, very important for this year. So students, please don't miss this topic of staircase wiring. Okay, now let's move on to our next topic, that is electromagnetism. In electromagnetism, every year you see students either AC or DC appears in your question paper. So this year I think that AC generator will be there in your question. And under AC generator, what are the probable questions which can appear? It is the uses of AC generator, the principle on which this AC generator or dynamo is based on, a simple diagram for AC generator, and thirdly, the energy conversion that takes place in an AC generator. Then we have our next topic, that is electromagnetic induction. Under electromagnetic induction, yes, you can have application based questions where they can show you a solenoid and they can show you a magnet moving towards the solenoid, and they can ask you what are the polarities developed on the ends and how you are finding the polarity, by which law you are using those to find the polarity of the circuit. So based on that, I have found that definition is important. the application based question which I mentioned to you now, and Lenz's law, the definition of Lenz's law and how you are applying Lenz's law. So these things you need to know about electromagnetic induction. Then let's come to the next topic, that is calorimetry. Under calorimetry, greenhouse effect, what are the gases which the greenhouse effect produces, what are the harmful effects of greenhouse effect, etc. Then you have water as a coolant. Okay, water is an effective coolant, we all know. Which property of water makes it an effective coolant? So we all know what is the property which makes water an effective coolant? It has a very high specific heat capacity. That means for 1 degree C degradation in temperature or 1 degree C fall in temperature, water takes a lot of heat. It is around 4200 joule per kg per Kelvin or per degree C. Okay, so the question can be, why water is used as an effective coolant? Reason I'm giving you right now. Then we have more examples of water acting as a coolant or some other form which uses that specific heat capacity as an important stuff. Okay, so reasoning questions from here. Next we have relationship between capacity and specific heat capacity. We all know the relationship between them. Also with the relationship, I would like to tell you that please go through the units also, the units and their mathematical expression. Okay, now let's move on to the last topic of physics, that is radioactivity. Under radioactivity, please go through the properties of alpha, beta and gamma radiations. Under properties, I'll mention you some of the important properties like the penetrating power, the ionizing power, the biological damage they are doing, and if possible, please try to learn them in increasing or decreasing order, because that will be the type of question they will be giving you in the paper, like arrange alpha, beta and gamma radiations in increasing order of their penetrating power, or in decreasing order of their ionizing power, or how much biological damage they are doing to us. Okay, so in that order you have to mention them. Next is emission of alpha and beta particle. Emission of alpha and beta particle, alpha is helium, beta is electrons, we all know that. So when an alpha particle is emitted from any nucleus, what changes is made to that nucleus? So we all know the mass number is decreased by 4 and atomic number is decreased by 2. Okay, so that what are the changes that happen when an alpha particle is emitting or when a beta particle is emitting from a nucleus? That kind of question you need to do. And lastly, see, I have given you 2 examples. Not necessarily this example is going to appear in your paper. This I have given you just to show like what kind of fill in the blanks can come to you. Like you see here, sodium is there. Then we have magnesium and the fill in the blanks. And then a beta particle. So you need to write down what will be in this blank. Okay. So fill in the blank question. Complete the equation question. Numerical, very rare chances of a numerical coming. But okay, yeah, please go through the numerical also. Don't miss that part. So that may, this is all that may come from all the parts of physics. Also student, as I have discussed with you, not the questions but the topic wise explanation of the suggestions for ICSE 2019, please, I have written all the questions in the description box. Please go through the description box and see what are the important questions coming for ICSE 2019. And in case if you want any kind of suggestion or solution to those questions or any kind of explanations, please comment in the comment section. I'll definitely try to make a video on the explanation part. Thank you.